The ovulation cycle begins with the release of two hormones by the pituitary gland.
Follicle-stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone production are controlled by the hypothalamus.
This computer-like gland in the brain analyzes nervous signals from other areas of the brain that process emotions and environmental factors.
The hypothalamus also analyzes hormone signals that are produced by other glands in the endocrine system and the ovaries, like estradiol and progesterone.
All of these hormonal activities will determine how ovarian activity will function.
A woman's body is rather complex, but this system is very communicative.
With the sending of signals to each gland, this well-set machine creates an ovulation cycle.
Signals are then sent to the ovaries to release an egg.
The dominant egg will take the lead and will plow ahead to the next phase of its life.
After luteinizing hormone is released, ovulation usually occurs within 12 to 24 hours.
The egg then forms into a cyst, which will help nourish the egg when it is fertilized, corpus luteum.
In this stage is when you will have PMS symptoms like moodiness, water retention, and breast tenderness.
The last stage is when the fertilized egg attaches itself to the uterus.
A hormone called human chorionic gonadotropin will then be produced.
This hormone will send a signal to the ovary to continue producing progesterone.
If this signal is missed, 9 to 10 days later the uterine lining will shed, or the woman will menstruate.
On the first day of menstruation, another ovulation cycle begins.
The important thing to think about with each individual cycle is to know when the most fertile time is.
The egg has the potential to live up to 20 hours after it is released from the ovary.
It is also good to know that you can have an ovulation cycle without ovulating.
This usually happens with girls who have just started to menstruate, women who breastfeed, women going through menopause, or women who have longer cycles than 35 days.
On a side note, ovarian cancer can also be induced by the demands of a woman's cycle.
With the constant rebuilding of tissues and new cells, there is a large strain put on the body.
That is possibly why women who have children have a lesser chance of developing ovarian cancer.